Hey there guys, GrooveLorn here, and today I finally have another deck profile for you guys. It's been a while since we've done one, so I figured I should do some more and put them out there. So start off, as you can tell by the title of this video, this is my Rock Stun deck for the September 2012 ban list format. As you can see, there are two proxies because they have not come in the mail yet. So let's go ahead and get started. For monsters, we have two Beast King Barbaros. Not only is he an Earth monster, but he's also a great 3,000 beater when you have Skill Drain on the field, which I will be showing later. Two Block Golem, fantastic card that just came out in Return of the Duelist. What he does is, if all the monsters in your graveyard are Earth, you contribute this card to target two level 4 or lower Rock-type monsters in your graveyard, except Block Golem. Special summon those targets, but their effects that activate on the field cannot be activated this turn. So basically, this guy lets you do Xyz plays, he can let you just... Okay, Block Golem, get out two of the other dudes, and you can semi-lock down your opponent unless they want to start wasting spells and traps. So, fantastic card that came out. Rockstun really needed it. And the reason I picked the deck up is because this guy finally came out in the U.S. Next, we have Gaia Plate, the Earth Giant. Fantastic card in this. He's basically a giant beater, especially with Red Eyes being semi'd. He is pretty much going to get over any of the major meta players right now with the 2800 attack, and you can special summon this card by removing play any two rock monsters in your graveyard, basically after you've used up the Block Golems, and you can special summon him. But during your standby phase, remove from play one rock type monster in your graveyard or send this card to the graveyard. Have the attack and defense of any monster that battles with this card. So basically what he'll do is you have to keep removing a rock monster, which is a pretty generous payment because he's pretty good. Same with, and then he can half the attack and defense of any monster that battles with this card. So basically, if your monster doesn't have anything that's 5600 attack, they're not getting over this dude with a monster. So great card in this deck. Next, we have three Go-Go-Go Giant. What this guy does is he can get himself out of the graveyard, and he's also a 2000 beater as well as a 4-star rock earth. So he fills all the good qualifications. So as long as you keep cycling these dudes, you can just bam, get another one, or then bam, get one. And so he's pretty good card in this. The 2000 is one of the biggest reasons to be running him in the Rockstone. And it lets you help go into some of your Xyz. Next, we have Grand Soil, the Elemental Lord. Also another new card that came out in Return of the Duelist, which is a fantastic card. Cannot be normal summoned or set. Must be sort of summoned by having exactly 5 Earth monsters in your graveyard. Kind of like Dark Armed, except, you know, Dark Armed has to have Dark Monsters. And cannot be special summoned by other ways. Boo! That'd be too broken otherwise. When this card is special summoned, you can target one monster in either player's graveyard. Yes. Special summon that target to your side of the field. If this card leaves the field, skip the battle phase of your next turn. So this guy is freaking awesome. He's not only a Monster Reborn for pretty much free, because just boom, Monster Reborn. He also can let you get from your opponent's graveyard, which is the best part, because like say you're fighting something that just has huge monsters that you just can't get over, if you finally kill one, you can just drop him and take it. So great card, also 2800 attack, which sets the standard for your boss monsters in this deck, so they're going to be hard to get over. And plus, his downside is, you know, can't attack next battle phase, but if you lost this dude, you already lost some pretty hefty field presence, so you're not going to want to be fighting next turn anyways. It's a pretty small price to pay. Next, we have three Kokai Miru Guardians. These are basically your Effect Veilers, except they're actually on the field and have 1900 bodies. So they're 4-star, Rock, Earth, all that fun stuff. But these guys will just let you, oh, you want to try to use your Sheehan? Nope. Or, oh, you want to try to use your any monster effect ever, because it doesn't only say from the field. So yeah, it's like, oh, I'm gonna try to hand trap, nope, or any kind of any monster effect, which is great, unlike some Xyz cards called Photon Strike Bouncer that won't be named. We have two Kokai Miru Sandman. These are the trap negation. They're not bad. All of these are pretty much the same stat numbers. These ones are less as good. They'd probably side these against anything like Chaos Dragons or anything that doesn't use a lot of spells and trap, or a lot of traps, because it's kind of hard to negate. Or, like, there's not as many traps being run nowadays compared to older formats, but still a great card. 1900 Rock, 4-star. We also have 3 Kokai Miru Wall. This is your spell negation and probably one of the best of the Kokai Miru in this deck, because it's going to be like they're going to have to start wasting a ton of resources in order to get over this dude, which is always great because this deck is entirely like your opponent's asking, may I do this? And you get to decide whether you say yes or no. And finally, last monster, Neospatian Grandmull. It is a rock, it's 3-star, so if you have this out and then a block golem, if you have no targets, you can just overlay for 3. Also, he has a great target for block golem, just not during that turn. Next, we have our spells, which most of them are self-explanatory. 1 Dark Hole, 2 Forbidden Lance to get over some of the bigger stuff that you just can't handle, as well as to maybe if you have a card or two that you want to have, like Grandmull that you want to get over, Skill Drain while it's down, or something along those lines. Heavy Storm, Monster Reborn, 3 Mystical Space Typhoon. Finally, 2 Pot of Duality. This is sad it went down to 2. I'm not sure why Konami did that, but if I could run 3, I would. And that's it for the spells. Let's go ahead and move on to the traps. 2 Bottomless Trap Hole, 2 Call of the Haunted to get back your block golems, 2 Dark Bribe for more just saying no to your opponent. Double Skill Drain. I love this card in this because all of your monsters will get over it because their costs are to tribute themselves. So that's the reason I won the Beast King, is because, oh look, I'm going to have a 3,000 beater now. 1 Solemn Judgment, 2 Solemn Warning. Finally, 1 Huge Revolution is over. I use this over Starlight Road because Starlight Road can be Solemn Warninged and as a counter trap. So only another counter trap will stop this, namely like Dark Bribe or Solemn Judgment. So it's an overall, I like this one better than Starlight Road, because not only does it stop it, it banishes the card that do it. So, like, I tried doing a Black Rose play, and this was used against me, so I lost Black Rose, which sucked. Now for the extra deck, we have 3 Temtempo, the Percussion Djinn. This one's okay, it helps get through maybe some, Zen Mains or something like that. All of the monsters in this extra deck are Earth to accommodate Block Golem, so it's not the best lineup, so there's 3 of these. There's going to be 2nd and 3rd of these, but Soul of Silver Mountain. Great card. Lets you again keep reusing your Block Golem, which is one of the main components of this deck, is just keep bringing out that Block Golem to keep plussing for days. 2 for now as well. There's going to be a 3rd. Fairy King, a word I can't pronounce. It's good. It's okay when you have Skill Drain out, but when Skill Drain's not out, this guy is fantastic, because anything that's 2800 is now on the same level as him, or anything that's 2750 is now 50 lower than him. So it's pretty good to try to get down some of their bigger monsters to a more manageable level. Next, we have 3 Gem Knight Pearl. It's just a great 2600 beater, gets over most of the meta monsters, as well as it's not an effect monster, and 3 Wind Up Zenmeister. He's not great, he's 1900 under Skill Drain. Not under Skill Drain, he's 25, but again, he's Earth, and that's really all we've got in TCG right now. So here are kind of the main focuses or goals of the deck. Obviously, like any Skill Drain that runs Beast King is pretty much a win condition in these kind of decks. It's just Skill Drain, 3,000, free 3,000 beater. What's not to love? Then with the Block Golem, you have access to, you have all of these dudes that you can bring back. Biggest thing, though, is to get back these Kokomiros, to just keep stopping your opponent from doing things. That's the main goal of any stun deck. You just tell your opponent, no, 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 no. So we've got all of the stuff, so you'll get either a 2,000 attack beater, or you can get stuff that bounce, or you can say no to spells, say no to traps, say no to drugs. And then the Go-Go-Go Giants allow you to really easily go into your rank 4s. Your Wind-Up Zenmeister, Gem Knight Pearl, and Fairy King, name I can't pronounce. So that's about it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Please remember to comment, rate, and like the video. That helps a lot. And subscribe if you aren't already. So remember, it's not the size of your deck that matters. It's what you put in.